I can hardly believe that I am saying this, but it has now been a year since Dave and I moved to Finland. Where has this year gone by? Does it feel as fast for you guys as it does for me? Because I feel like this year has just gone woof, just like that. Because I was feeling a little bit sentimental about it now being a whole year since we moved here, I watched an old video of mine titled something along the lines of why I'm excited. What was that? Oh my god. We'll get to this later, but I don't know if that you can hear that through the mic, but they've just reinstalled the boxing bag underneath our flat and it makes an annoying sound. I'm sorry if you can't hear that. Where was I? Anyway, so to commemorate our 1 year in Finland, I watched this video and it's pretty cute. So I thought it would be fun to now, a year later, see if these incredible expectations that I had have matched reality and if I'm as excited about all these things now after a year. I'll put in some clips from the video so we can all laugh at how like stupidly excited I was about everything. Because life is, in fact, that little bit sweeter in Finland. Okay. So I mentioned the hot and cold taps in the beginning of the video, but I don't think that's really something that we need to discuss because it's stupid. I mean, I already knew that that wasn't gonna be a thing once we moved to Finland. But then I talked about the water pressure.
I think it was Dave who said that our shower at home feels like an old man peeing on you.
For someone who's lived in London, I mean, water pressure, it just cannot be taken for granted. And I will still sometimes stand in the shower and be like, wow. Reality has really probably exceeded my expectations there. Then I thought it was really cute that I mentioned the electrical outlets in the bathroom.
But I'm pretty excited about the prospect of having an electrical outlet in the bathroom so that you can dry your hair or plug in your electric toothbrush.
So yes, I'm happy to report that I now have my hair dryer in the bathroom. And I love it so much. Then I thought this was quite funny as well. I mentioned carpet and the fact that nobody in Finland has carpet, like indoors. Like, I'm not talking about rugs or mats, but like, you know, all covering carpet. And I said in the video,
okay, fine, maybe we won't have hardwood floors. I don't care. It can be laminate floors or whatever. Hell, I'll even take like a plastic, whatever it's called, as long as it's not carpet.
And as you might be even, yeah, able to see there in the frame. Yeah, we have plastic floor in this student flat of ours. It's fine. So much better than carpet any day of the week. Then I mentioned in the video that I was so excited because I was convinced that in Helsinki you couldn't hear your neighbors.
Because Finnish buildings are so well insulated, the walls are very thick, everything is very well soundproofed.
And some people did kind of pull me back down to earth on that point and say that, well, they hear their neighbors, so it's not all 1 meter thick concrete walls in each building. But we've been quite happy here in this flat. We've never heard anyone like talk or heard a TV or anything like that. But there is a man or a woman. I don't know why I think it's a man. I don't know. There's a person who is playing the guitar, and not like an acoustic guitar, but like a, what's it called, electric guitar. Like this. And that's quite annoying. We can hear them every now and then. I don't love that. And then also, as you might have been able to hear earlier, we have this annoying heavy bag or whatever it's called, like a boxing bag hanging in the gym underneath our flat, which is, you know, great. The only problem is that it's attached to the ceiling, which is our floor. So a little before Christmas, I think it was, somebody managed to pull down the bag, or like the bag came off. And we have been so grateful to not hear this really annoying like sound when like the metal of the chain is in the attachment. And I don't know how it works, but we've been so happy because it's been gone. But then yesterday they came and fixed it. And yeah, this morning we've already heard some really annoying noises, and it's even, if possible, a more annoying noise than it was before. So, not super happy about that. So there, I would say that maybe reality hasn't really, you know, met the expectations on that front. Then I was really cute when I was so excited about the public transport, and I think I like went on for like a full minute about how you can use the same ticket and get on and off.
And that's amazing, because that means that you can go from metro to bus to tram and you can use the same ticket.
And I mean, it is great. I just don't know why I was that excited about it, but it's great. It's super duper great. Then, to continue my embarrassment, I was also insanely excited about the Stockmann sales event, Hullutpäivät, Crazy Days.
I told Dave about this a few minutes ago and I literally got like goosebumps when I said it. But I just love the atmosphere. I just love it so much.
This is so funny because for someone who is so like anti-consumerism and doesn't buy a lot of stuff and you know, is very like ecologically conscious, it's so weird to me that I'm so like pro this like massive shopping sales event. It literally goes against like everything that I believe in, but somehow it just excites me. I can't explain it. I mean, I'm not proud of it. But yes, I have experienced two of these events now. And it has been everything that I've wanted and more. Then I also mentioned going to the cinema and having subtitles.
On the Finnish cinema, they do subtitles both in Finnish and Swedish, which is pretty damn impressive, I have to say.
This isn't something that I've really thought about. I was excited about this before coming here, but I haven't really thought about it. And we have been to the cinema quite a lot. Because we get invited to these like free screenings or pre-screenings or premieres or something like that. But I've forgotten to be grateful for the subtitles. So next time I will make a point to be grateful for the subtitles so that I can hear what or like know what they're saying when I'm eating my crunchy popcorn. I think that was one of the reasons why I was so excited about the subtitles.
You know when you're watching something and you're eating, you might not hear so well, so then it's good to have subtitles. This is becoming a whole different thing, but do you guys know what I mean? I find that very helpful.
Then I was excited about seeing all the seasons. This was also something that a couple of Brits or other people a little bit wanted to argue with me about, saying that there are all the seasons in London as well. But I disagree. It's just my personal opinion, so you can't say that I'm wrong. But yeah, I think my point was that a lot of the seasons just kind of blend boringly into one.
Whereas in Finland, I feel like it's, you know, in the spring, everything's like neon green and it's such a dramatic change from the winter. And then summer is, you know, glorious.
And oh my gosh, have we been treated to beautiful seasons since moving here. Spring was fantastic last year. Summer was obviously amazing. The autumn was so beautiful. And the winter has been quite okay. I mean, sure, it's been a bit cold and it's been snowy, but now it's 20th of March and I think we are approaching springtime again. Then I mentioned, this was so cute, I mentioned the fact that I could just pick up my parents' car when I needed to borrow a car and drive it.
I can just do that. Imagine, I'll be at home and I'll be like, oh, I would need a car to get there, and I can just call them up and ask to borrow the car. It's revolutionary.
But I don't think I remembered at that point that I would be living in Helsinki and my parents would be living in Inko, which is 45 minutes outside of the city. So, I mean, that has really not happened. So that's everything that I was excited about before moving here. And now having been here for a year, I mean, I think we're doing quite well here. I think we're quite happy living here. It's weird because when people ask us like, oh, how does it feel now? You've been here for a year. Like, do you like living in Finland? And I'm kind of like, yeah. I mean, I just don't have a lot of strong opinions about it. I think I've said this before in a video. And it's such an exciting time now as well, like with spring coming and I only have two courses left in my studies and I'm handing in my thesis in 3 weeks. So yeah, it's gonna be so nice to see what this spring kind of brings with it and what the future holds, like post-studies, post-master's degree. Yeah, it'll be exciting. I really can't wait till I've handed in my thesis because then I have so much less work to do and then I can concentrate much more on making videos. I really like, I'm just waiting for that day. I'm so excited. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope that you enjoyed it and I will see you again very soon. Bye!
He always makes fun of me because I always say, well, in Finland, blah, blah, blah. Or, you know, claim that something works better in Finland. Because let's face it, we all know that it does.